very much, Kathy, and hello there, everybody. This is Craig at Max Trading, and it is a true pleasure to welcome you to our real-time trading session today. Good to have you in the room with us. Thanks for your participation. Today, we're looking for the U.S. Jobs News Report to provide some nice price action for us. Of course, we don't ever know exactly what will happen, what the numbers will be, or what the market reaction will prove to be, but we like to be ready. And so the max charts are up, and we'll be taking advantage of whatever the market provides for us. We appreciate the opportunity to show you how max trading methods take advantage of movement when it comes in the markets, and very importantly, how our risk management protects the account balance. We do ask that you please remember this is not a trading room, and we are not providing trade calls today. Nothing that you see or hear during this webinar is to be taken as entry or exit recommendations. All of it is for educational purposes for our webinar today. Eusebio is here to lead us into the charts for this NFP session. I know that some of you are meeting Eusebio for the first time, and you are about to discover that he is a highly skilled trader. And I believe you will also quickly come to realize that he truly enjoys helping traders. So I hope you have opportunity to listen and to watch very carefully. You'll learn a lot as you watch him trade and listen to his comments. And please feel free to ask questions anytime throughout the session. The methods that you will see today are taught in the MAX courses, which begin next week, or you can begin your training anytime by making use of our videos. We do provide very nice discounts for those who take the time to attend our webinars or to watch the video playback, and we'll be providing those links for you. Eusebio, I think that's all the preliminaries, and we're ready to get started. Thank you so much for sharing your time with us, and I'll pass the microphone along to you.
So welcome to this presentation about the MAX with the non-farm payroll. I hope you are all fine. And I'm glad to see so many people attending today's session. We are going to see what the non-farm payroll will give us. We will have in 10 minutes, indeed, an important news release, which is the non-farm payroll. And at the same time, if you closely watch calendar news release, the unemployment rate, and both must go in agreement. The big boys analyze all with these two news together. And this is why the non-farm payroll is always a difficult news release. Because, in fact, in order to have directional and sustainable movement in virtually all the pairs we can have with the eight main currencies, we need to have the two news releases, the non-farm payroll and the unemployment rate, in agreement. This means either a good number in the non-farm payroll and a good number in the unemployment rate. This means for the non-farm payroll a number way, way larger than the forecast by at least 40 to 50K, and a smaller one for the unemployment rate, or vice versa. A bad number for the non-farm payroll with a number 40 to 50K less than the forecast, and a larger number for the unemployment rate. So they are one is the inverse of the other, in fact. In all the other cases, we don't have a predictable movement. And so the movements are way more difficult to trade because we may have extreme choppiness in the market for a while. At the same time, we have the equivalent of the non-farm payroll and the unemployment rate for the Canadian dollar, so in Canada. And then, and this is also important to know, because they are not always mentioned in the economical calendar, 2 minutes after the non-farm payroll, we have the revision for the previous months. And so this is why, even if we have a big surprise in the non-farm payroll and the unemployment rate, we don't need to rush. We have to wait. If we have a big surprise with good numbers or bad numbers, we will see volatility. We never try to trade the spikes we are seeing with important news release, but the movement after the volatility will settle down. We have 2 hours in front of us, and so we will see what the news will give us. Let me show one of my charts to explain the structure of my chart. So here on the chart, I'm showing, for example, the pound US dollar. You see some of our indicators on the chart. The two main indicators are these two lines in yellow and in orange. They are called our ETF lines. These lines help us to pinpoint important reversal for highs and lows in what we call ETF trend, max ETF trend. And the trend itself, because during a trend we may have a pullback, the trend itself is defined by its companion indicator, which is this indicator at the bottom of the chart with two lines, one in green and red. When this line, which we call the slow bias, is green, we look only for up movement and so consequently long trades. And when the slow bias is red, we look for a downtrend and we look consequently only for short trades. And we have another line here in blue and orange, which is called the fast bias, which helps to confirm in some circumstances, either when the trend is reversing, we can sometimes anticipate a trend reversal, or when we consider specific entry setups, which are specific price patterns we want to see in order to catch the beginning of a trend in terms of trade. On the main chart, we have some moving averages. They are classical moving averages to define the quality of the trend when we are on one side or the other of what we call our home base. It is a long-term moving average corresponding approximately to 200 periods in the time frame we consider, in this case, defined in the time frame. And then you can see also these horizontal lines in white, in orange. There are other on the chart at different levels. They are called the max price levels, and they represent levels of supply and demand, or if you want to call them, I don't necessarily agree with these names, support and resistance. I prefer to consider them as supply and demand. And these lines are defined each Saturday, and so the line you are seeing here for the moment have been defined last Saturday, so 1 week ago, and you can see how the price still react to these levels even today. Look here how the price has made a small pause on this line at this level before crossing down this level. I like to draw my rectangles in yellow. They are better seen so in the on the screen. And then we have the previous level here. Look here. We had two levels. The colors are not important. They simply help me to remember which time frame I have used to define them, because I have a multi-time frame approach to define the supply and demand level. And look how the price just after the London Open has reacted in that area. A line is never a thick line. We have always to consider a small zone around a level. And so when we are at a demand level, the zone is something, for example, like that. If I consider the white line, the zone would be something like that. And if we are in a supply demand, the zone will be below. This is important because when the price, look here again how the price has reacted on that level, so just before the US Open. Because when the price takes off one of these levels, they are less meaningful. If they are level of support of supply and demand, this means that there are at these levels some pockets of liquidities. When these liquidities have been taken completely, these levels become useless. We never know, because we don't know all the volumes in the market, we never know if all the liquidities are taken completely. And so this is why we keep them during the entire week, just in the case the price will still react, and this happens very, very frequently. So now let's have a quick look on the news. You all know where you can get the news release. There are many economical calendars. We like to use the calendar from Forex Factory because it is really easy to read. We have for the non-farm payroll, I will consider only the US dollar. We have as the non-farm payroll change a forecast of 188K, and for the unemployment rate, 4%. So we will need to have a big deviation, bad or good, to have a very high, almost 100% probability to see a good movement. In all the other cases, I consider it is not a trading day. In such a case, because we may have two issues, either we will have a movement or not. If we have a movement, I will show you how the rules of the max apply to this movement. If not, I will show you, taking one of the pairs I'm displaying, how the trade risk management helps to minimize the risk we have on a trade when we force a trade. Because most of the time, when we force a trade, this means when we take a trade which is not a trade we should take, we call that forcing a trade, very, very often this trade ends as a losing trade. And so this is why we never force the trade with the max. But it may still be a good opportunity to show how the trade risk management in such a case helps to minimize the consequences. Sometimes we get a profitable trade, sometimes we get so losing trade, and so I will show you. But if we have good numbers or bad numbers with a surprise, so we will have the opportunity to show how the trends we may have can be handled with the max rules. So we have just to wait. We have we have 2 minutes to, before the first news release. When you consult economical calendar, you have many, many, many news. And they are generally coded in terms of high impact, medium impact, or low impact in the market. Unfortunately, these coding are not always accurate. And if you want to have more information about the real significance or the real relevance of the news release, you can consult our website. Chris will write down on the chat the address of the website, www.maxtradingsystem.com/newswatch. And so on that page, I cannot show the page now because my terminal is set up for MetaTrader. So www.maxtradingsystem.com/newswatch, and Craig will write the link in the chat area. So you will see for the week, for all the day of the week, the news which are really important. On the page, you will see a small explanation on how to interpret these informations. You will see also what we call the top 10 pair, what are the pair which are moving the most. And you will see also, and this is prepared every Saturday, you will see also the pair we suggest to monitor for each day depending on the news release. And so today, the suggested pair were, for example, the pound US dollar, the pound yen, the pound Aussie, the pound kiwi, and the pound cat. And I always like to observe the euro US dollar, and so consequently also the euro yen, and I have added the euro cat because we have also news on the cat. Okay, the news is released. Let's see what are the numbers. We don't need to rush, because as I have said, we never tried to catch the spice. We will have to wait for a pullback or a retracement. I will explain in a moment why. So let's wait for the numbers in the calendar. So we have 103, so 103K, so we have a big, big negative deviation for the non-farm payroll. Let's see if we will have a bad number for the unemployment rate. So if we have a larger number than 4% for the unemployment rate, this will be a good opportunity for trends in the market. We have 4.1%. Okay, we have two numbers in agreement. We have a big negative deviation in the non-farm payroll and a worse number in the unemployment rate. We still have to wait for the revision, in 1 minute now. And now let me explain how we handle this kind of situation. And I will take any pair. I will consider, for example, here the pound US, or let's take the euro US dollar. it doesn't matter. So generally, when we have a big deviation, as it is the case, we have an important spike. The spike was around, it is not a so big one on the euro-US dollar for the moment, 23 pips, but we have the first spike, then we have a retracement. This is the second step of the news release. The movement associated with the news release, the retracement can be a small one, it can be an important one, and then we should see normally in a third step, in a few minutes most probably, the price resuming, in this case the up movement on the euro-US dollar, because a bad number on the US dollar weakens the US dollar, and with the US dollar weakening, we should see the euro-US dollar going upward. So we are seeing the retracement now. And see, the retracement has been almost immediate, and the price has retraced entirely the long bar, the large candle. We can see that also on the pound US dollar. We can see that on the euro. We can see that, in fact, in all the pairs we are following. So, and so, let's see when the volatility will slow down. So I repeat, we have had a bad number in the non-farm, a bad number in the unemployment rate, so we should see a rather good movement today on many pairs. And let me check quickly for the CAD. We have a good number in the employment change and no change in the unemployment rate. So no big opportunity in the CAD itself, but in relationship with the non-farm payroll in USA, we can expect some good movements. Let's have a quick look, for example, on a pair like the pound kiwi. I like to consider sometimes the pound kiwi, and so here we have a 24 pips candle only. By the way, we can quickly see that all the trends are to the downside, except that now on the pound US dollar here, we may have, on the pound Aussie, we may have a reversal to the upside, a companion, so the slow bias indicator is turning to the upside. So, and also in the euro US dollar. So now let's wait a few minutes before considering any opportunity on one of these pairs. As long as the volatility is important, with the max, we have as a rule to never consider opening a trade. You can see, for example, on the pound yen, how the price has reacted around this level here. Now let's see what the price will do on the euro US dollar. On this level, the price is reaching price level, a max price level for the moment at around one spot 22.55-56. Well, let's see. I'm trying to catch for a good opportunity in any of the pairs we have. We may have perhaps an opportunity on the Euro CAD here. Remember, the CAD number were good numbers, but we have to wait for the appropriate setup. We begin to see another retracement. We need to see an important pullback before considering any trade. With the max, whenever we have a long bar like this one, we always wait for a pullback before considering any trade opening, because whenever we have a long bar like this one, most of the time, not always of course, but most of the time, an entry at the extreme of a long bar is not a good point, a good price to open a new trade, because the risk for a pullback is very, very important. So, and you can see how the price is posing around this level. Concerning the levels, we have two formula. We have a free subscription formula and we have a paying subscription formula. For the free subscription, and Chris will also put a link where you can require to be included in that list. So we provide these levels for free for four pairs, the euro, US dollar, the euro, Aussie, the Aussie yen, and the pound yen. So every week, I send a template helping to display these levels on the chart, and we have a small script allowing to import, to copy these levels from the chart to your own chart where you display your own template. And with the paying formula, we have many more pairs, generally between 15 and 20 pairs, plus some indices, the S&P 500, the Dow Jones, the Nasdaq, the DAX, gold, oil. And I have recently included a few months ago, at the demand by many, the Bitcoin, even if I do not agree myself to trade the Bitcoin. But so we have between 25 and 30 instruments I analyze, so every weekend. And the levels are valid for the entire coming week. So now we are seeing the pullback. So I remember that usually when we have a big deviation in an important news release, we see first of all the spike in the direction of the news. This is the first step. Then we have a pullback more or less important, and then we have the price resuming the movement in the direction of the spike in agreement with the news release, which is what I call the fundamental movement. Sometimes before the news release, this may be a pre-step, in fact, but this does not always happen. Sometimes we see during the 5 to 15 minutes before the news release some speculative movement with a lot of volatility, which may also occur in the price movement. So we can see that on a pair like the euro US dollar, the trend is possibly reverse into the upside because our slow bias is turning from red to green, and so which would be in agreement with the news release. So let's wait at least the close of this candle in 40 seconds approximately, and let's see if we will get on the next bar a good opportunity, or on any of the other pairs. You can see, for example, on the euro card we may have a setup opportunity here, which will be right on the side of this max price level. I'm going to show you also how we handle trade with what we call our max trade monitor, which is an EA, which helps to execute a trade . And I will explain just in a moment how we use that tool. So we had here a good short setup for this candle. We like to draw it with a green vertical line, a dashed green vertical line. And once we have the setup bar, we define an entry price level, which in this case will be at this level exactly. So if the price hit this level, I will consider a short trade, and I have to place my stop loss. And my stop loss, I will place my stop loss. It will be a rather large stop loss, which is, oh my God, the price is going very fast. I will not sell the price here. Let's see if the price will come back. This is always a problem when we have a news like the non-farm payroll. The price is moving very, very fast. It has already moved 5 pips. But otherwise, this would have been my entry. I missed the entry. Sorry for that. I have been not fast enough. This sometimes happens. So let's wait on another pair. So we are seeing the retracement playing in the euro US dollar pair and in the pound US dollar. No setup here, no setup here, not yet. No setup here, no setup here, we have to wait, and no setup here. So let's see if the price will come back on the euro card. And so in the meantime, so we have 2 minutes before the close of the bar. Let me explain quickly what we have on our tool. This tool is a one-click button to handle the trade, a sell, an MX, an XXX. And whenever we open a trade, a buy or a sell, the EA calculates automatically the trade size with the position sizing concept, using here our stop loss and the financial risk we take on the trade, for example, 1%, so 2 units, 1 unit returns half of the trade, an MX, which means a momentum exit, closes 1 unit, and the XXX closes all the remaining opened unit, because of course, with the max, we can use, I will not trade it today, but we can use a scaling process. So adding progressively to the trade in order to build progressively a larger position under very specific conditions. So we are seeing the price coming back, so this would be a good point to make an entry. And then on this panel, we have data about the position. So we have two columns, a column named symbol, which corresponds to the symbol for which a trade has been opened, and if there are several trades running simultaneously, being simultaneously opened, we have a global column given the result for all the pairs simultaneously. On these columns, we have two main informations, the XX ESL result. ESL is our emergency stop loss, so it's the result of the trade should the trade close on the ESL line, wherever the ESL is, because we may adjust the stop loss while the trade is running, and the XXX result, XXX profit, which is the result of the trade at the moment we close the trade. This represents at any moment during the life of the trade the potential results. It will be the result if we close the trade at any moment while the trade is open. So. And so these two, we have the risk and we have the potential result. So when we know how to use these numbers, they help greatly to handle the trade. It's a pity I have missed the entry here. So this is always the problem when we have such a news release and we have to explain what we are doing. But you knew that I would have made my entry here should I have been fast enough, and I have drawn my entry before the price, just after the close of the previous price, the previous candle, before the price has hit that level. So we will see how the price will move, but in the meantime, let's see if we will get another opportunity, perhaps on the pound US dollar, if this candle closes as a blue candle in a few minutes. So or this candle, if it closes as a blue candle on the pound Aussie, because the trend is reversing to the upside, or on the pound, sorry, the pound Aussie, yeah, and on the pound Kiwi too. No, not yet, because we are still red here on the trend. The euro US dollar seems good too. Let me have a quick look. Yes, at the close of this candle, we will get, but it is not in agreement with the expected movement. The data have been bad for the US dollar, we should see normally the US dollar weakening. So taking a short trade on the euro US dollar makes no sense for me. We should consider only long trades. Okay, let's prepare for the, let's consider for example here the pound Aussie. I will use also, so it's too late for the pound, the euro CAD. So let's consider the pound Aussie. The pound Aussie is a bit choppy, but we have a clear trend reversal. So I will also apply my max trade monitor on this pair. That way. Where is my stop loss? The stop loss is here. And let's set the stop loss somewhere in this area. In this area. We have a stop loss which will be rather large, but anyway, and this time I will try to be fast enough. The button is here. You see, the setup would have been a good one on the euro CAD. The price has already moved by 18 pips. So 1 minute to go to see if we will get a trade setup. Let me check more carefully. No, we have something more here. The price is in a price mode we call a consolidation zone mode. And we can see clearly that we have here a resistance level. We can even put it a little lower in this area, and we'll have as an additional condition that this candle must be a blue candle and must close above this level. So in a few seconds now, and then we will have to check other conditions. Not only the breakout is necessary, but we will need also to see, for example, a blue color in our fast bias, which doesn't seem to be the case. So this will not be now. The probability to have a setup is very small, virtually zero now. No. It's not an entry setup, so we have to wait. All the conditions are not fulfilled, so we still have to wait for the pound Aussie. Let's have a quick look to the other pairs. Nothing here, nothing here, nothing here. Nothing on the pound yen. Nothing on the, perhaps on the pound kiwi here. On the pound, no, not yet. We want to see the fast bias turning from red to green to have a long setup. It is not the case yet, so patience. And so we have to wait for another 5 minutes. Let's have a quick look where the price is on the pound. So as you remember, I have said that my entry would have been here. So the execution would have been right there on the bid price because it is a short trade, and the stop loss was right on this red line. I will show you manually, unfortunately, how we would have handled that trade. The price has moved by around 17 pips. The stop loss size was 34 pips. Let me write it on the chart. 34 pips ESL. 34 pips. And so what I do myself for my profit I always consider a first MX only if the price has moved by here 17 plus the spread 21, only if the price moves somewhere in this area, or if I have an exit setup and a price triggering on or below this level. Let me recheck. Yes, 21 pips, which is 17 plus the spread, 4 pips. So why? Because I like to make my first MX with a profit. When we have to make an MX, we have two choices, either making the MX systematically when we have an exit setup appearing, or as an alternative, we call that a discretionary decision when the profits on the set on the DMX is large enough. We don't have a trend reversal yet on the pound TV, so let's come back to the pound Aussie, because now we may have possibly a setup appearing in 1 minute and 40 seconds. And now we can see that the slow bias, the fast bias seems to turn to blue, which will be an additional condition to have a valid entry setup. We have a restrict rules or conditions when we want to open a trade. So 1 minute. Now, when we have a big surprise in the news release, I have said we have almost always an important movement following. This is not 100% certain. Sometimes it happens that the movement does not follow. This means that there has been other reasons in the market the big boys have considered more important than the news itself. So this sometimes happens. Okay, 15 seconds, 13. Let's try to be ready. Okay, here I will set my entry. Oh, the price is really moving very fast. Where is my price entry? It should be here. Right here. We are almost. And it is now a buy. This is the setup bar. The price is retracing, so we have to wait. Okay, the trend has not reversed yet on the pound kiwi. Now price is coming back on the euro US dollar. I like that, because now the movement will be in agreement with the news. And we have similarly on the pound US dollar, but this candle for me is not a very good entry setup. and it is even not a valid entry setup. So this means that the volatility has not settled down yet. So we have to wait with patience. Sometimes I remember it has happened that I have had to wait 2 hours, 3 hours before having a good opportunity to open a trade. The Euro-US dollar may offer also perhaps an opportunity. Let me check. No, not yet. Not yet. We need to have that fast bias to be blue. It is not the case. So the prices on all the pairs are retracing. So patience, patience. Now we have also more advanced ways to open a trade, but when the price are moving rather fast, like today here, I don't have the time to give any explanations, so I don't use these more advanced techniques, but I'm sure that some of our maxers are already in some trades. Nothing yet on the Euro-US dollar, unfortunately. Nothing yet on the Pound-US dollar. No, no valid setup for the moment. So as you can see, we never consider that we have to jump right away on a trade when we open our screens. We want to wait for the appropriate conditions in order to have a good winning rate for our trade. So these candles are going to close. So no, indeed, we don't have an entry setup yet on the Euro-US dollar as well as on the Pound-US dollar. Now, the next bar may be a good one. Maybe a good one because now we are seeing that the fast bias are turning to the appropriate color and the price is coming back inside the concession zone area here for the pound Aussie. And so we will have to wait either for a new breakout, giving possibly a better entry price level, or if the price hits my previous entry level, which is still on my chart. There is no reason to change the stop loss for the moment. The price is retracing completely on the euro card. This sometimes happens, of course. And now something is progressively being set in place also for the pound yen. The upside, the trend is reversing. As reversed, the fast bias is turning to the appropriate color, but we need to wait for the appropriate setup, and you see the price is moving around this price level. Now, usually when we have a big surprise in the non-farm payroll and in the unemployment rate, as it is the case today, usually the price moves way farther and faster, usually. But these last two, 3 years, we are seeing a change in the price behavior. So sometimes, more often than in the past, even with a big surprise, it takes time for the fundamental movement to develop. And sometimes the price moves in the completely different, opposite direction. Which shows some uncertainty, in fact, in the market. I'm going to take off the trade manager from the Eurocard because I have missed the entry. I will mark manually the trade, so let's take off this one. So that I will have the opportunity to set it on another pair, perhaps the pound card or any of the other pairs if we have a valid entry setup. So maybe now in the euro US dollar, but the price is approaching, the price is too close to this max price level, so this area will not be a good entry level. It's better to wait for the price to cross that level, but then it will not provide a good entry price level because of what we are seeing here. So this is not a good opportunity. The potential will not be, even if we have an entry somewhere in this area, we don't have place enough if the price respects these level and bounces off even temporarily from these levels. So this level will be also, should be a breakout level before considering a good entry level. So otherwise, we can see we still have long bars, so the volatility has not settled down yet. For the pound US dollar, we have similarly situation is a bit different in the pound US dollar. We have place enough until the next price level. And so this candle can be, when it will close in 4 minutes, an entry setup. So let's follow also the pound US dollar. And this will be in agreement with the news release. What I'm going to do is I will move a little bit my chart to the left, that way. In such a way that I clearly see the price here when my chart is reduced. I don't like that entry. It doesn't follow the rules. The price is at a too extreme level compared to that spike, so this is not a good entry. I will skip it here. And in this case, the price was, we have the same situation, but the pattern follows better what we have, what we are looking for. The pullback has been deep enough. Let me recheck the euro US dollar. Yeah, in the euro US dollar also, but the price is already too far away. So not a good entry for the euro US dollar, but maybe for the pound US dollar. Let me prepare my max trade monitor on the pound US dollar. So here. I can already prepare for the stop loss. We have to 11, 3 minutes. So if I place my stop loss here, I will have a stop loss size of around 17 bit, but we have a lot of volatility. So I will place my stop loss way farther. We have that low, we have our home base. Yeah, I will set my stop loss here on this place. And this candle must close as a blue candle. All the other conditions are fulfilled. The next price level is far away, far enough away. Okay. So 2 minutes now. Let's have a quick look to what is happening on the other. The stop loss is right here, so we have still plenty of place for the Eurocat to still go in the right direction. The pound Aussie is coming back. We have also an opportunity on the pound Kiwi developing. But my rule is also to never have more than two trades opened simultaneously. In order to reduce the risk we have on the entire position. If I take, for example, a 1% risk on the pound Aussie and a 1% risk on the pound US dollar, I have a total risk of 2%, okay? Okay, my entry on this should be at 35.5 in this area. We are here, so let's make a buy. Okay, we have here I can use a better entry right here. Buy. Okay. We are now on two trades, one on the pound US dollar, one on the pound Aussie. Now, let's see how these trades will evolve. Now, what I do, usually when I have two trades being opened, I widen my chart that way. Yeah, I terminal, view terminal. Trade, you can see the two trades on the pound US dollar and on the pound Aussie have been open. The pound US dollar with 36 micro lots or 3.6 mini lots, and the pound Aussie with a little more than half mini lot. Okay? And so now we have to monitor the two pairs. Sorry, this is the euro US dollar. Not the pound Aussie, of course. It is not the right pair. I'm sorry for that. Where is the euro US, pound US dollar? It's here. Okay. Okay. Now we are on the right pair. And I will keep my button close to the price. Now you can see that the risk on each pair is almost 1%. Okay, a little less than 1% because we have always a round off in the size of the trade. The round off is set to the smaller number on the second digit. And you can see how the XXX profit is evolving for each pair, and you have the global position with the two pairs. And so on this pair, this was my entry setup bar. And now I can take out these lines here. My setup was this line. And now we have to handle the... I have been a little too fast here with the pound Aussie. Let me check. Yes, no, because I have missed the entry on this. Yeah, I have been a little too fast. Anyway, the trade has been taken, so I should have waited for this line to be blue. You see? So in the hurry to take a trade, I have been a little bit impatient. Anyway, this shows that a human being, even if he masters the methodology, can still make small errors in the trade. Anyway, when a trade is opened, the trade is opened. So now let's see how we will handle these two situations. So in the first case, so the stop loss size was, so in this case, 33, let's say 34 pips, I will take my first profit only if the price moved by 17 pips or more, and 17 pips is just a little bit below this max price levels. And for the pound Aussie here, we have 29, so 14 and a half plus the spread, 14 and a half, 14, 15, 18, 18 pips will be, 18 pips will be right on this level, somewhere here, and here I have to add the spread, so 3 pips, so at 585 here. Because we have, of course, to take into account the spread. And now we wait patiently for two kinds of situations. The first type of situation is to close one unit. And for me, I need to wait for the price to at least reach or go over that level indicated by my blue aqua horizontal line. I use a discretionary way to make my first entry and my first exit. And the second situation is, or of course the possibility is to close the trade on the stop loss. Okay, because we never know, the price can always go against the trade and give a losing trade. And the second situation will be a situation when I can reduce or I can adjust my stop loss. You will see the effect of adjusting the stop loss or closing one unit on the risk on the trade. These numbers, when I will take one of these two possibilities, to these two steps, will decrease importantly these numbers. And if the trade turns as a winning trade, at some point, maybe they will become risk-free. This means that these ESL results will turn to green. When they turn to green, this means that we will be in a risk-free trade. And if the number becomes larger than zero, it will be even a sure profitable trade. As long as the number stays in red, we still are facing a potential losing trade. Okay? Now, at the close of the next bar, in 3 minutes, as you will see, I will be able to move a little bit my stop loss on the pound Aussie. The risk per trade is 1%. This means that the result on the trade, when the trade will be closed, represent also the reward to risk ratio in terms of ratio and not in terms of percentage. Now, in terms of exit techniques, we have several types of exit techniques. First of all, a first group of exit techniques is based on the usage of some technical indicators. Now, a point must be clear when we use technical indicators. We do not use a technical indicator to try predicting what the price should do. there are no technical indicators predicting what the price will do. This doesn't exist. At best, they indicate what the price is doing now and what the price has made in a very recent past. Okay? For example, one of these indicators we are using is such a momentum indicator, which in fact is the stochastic of the RSI. An exit technique with such an indicator is when we are in a long trade, when the RSI makes a top, a specific type of top or a divergence, for example, we have an exit technique. But we have other patterns displayed by the indicators. The second category of exit technique is the pure price action. When the price is exhibiting specific price patterns, these patterns are also exit setups. The third type is what we call hybrid exit setups. It's a combination between the price pattern and some specific indicator on the main chart. In this case, the Bollinger Band or these small dotted magenta lines, which we call in general either movement invalidation or movement exhaustion. The fourth type of exit techniques is based on timing consideration, because there are times during the day when we have to consider to close the trade. For example, should we have another news release while we are in a trade within the last 15 to 30 minutes before the news release, we close the trade. And then the last category, the fifth category of exit techniques we have is when the trend itself reverses and we get an entry setup in the opposite direction. How many lots did you buy on each? I have shown in the terminal, Ang. I have shown the terminal, okay? So view terminal here, you see. 3.6 mini lots for the pound US dollar and 5.4 mini lots for the pound Aussie, or in terms of micro lots, 36 micro lots on the pound US dollar, 54 micro lots on the pound Aussie dollar. Okay? Now, these exit techniques, as I have said for the technical indicator, have not the aim to predict what the price will do. They have the aim to tell us when we have a risk appearing for the trade. And when that risk is big enough, and the exit techniques helps to quantify when the risk is big enough, so when the risk is big enough, this forces us to consider closing one unit. And we have rules to know where to make that exit, okay? In order to reduce that risk, and very often, of course, to bank a profit. Now that this blue candle has closed, you see the second candle after the entry, especially on the pound Aussie, gives me the opportunity to tighten a little bit my stop loss. Now, on the pound Aussie, look the risk. The risk is minus 0.99%, let's say 1%. A risk of 1% means that should the price reverse and hit that initial stop loss, my loss would be 1% of my trading account. Okay? Now I have the opportunity to tighten a little bit my stop loss by a few pips, by 8 pips. Look how this risk will be reduced. Not a lot, but it will be reduced somewhat. And I will now adjust my stop loss right here. The stop loss has been taken into account. It is handled by the MaxTrade monitor. And you can see that now the risk on that trade has been reduced to 0.75%. Okay? And I'm still waiting on the pound US dollar for an opportunity to tighten my stop loss. But I have to watch closely what will happen if the price will reach that area. For the pound Aussie, we have plenty of time. The next level is way, way far away. So, and we were on the right side of this one. So above, so that's good. So our MTM MaxTrade Manager or MaxTrade Monitor calculates automatically, just to give you a complimentary answer, ANG. So the MaxTrade Monitor calculates automatically the trade size. So this trade size I have just shown, let's show it again. This trade size based on the size of the stop loss and based on the financial risk in percentage we take on the pair, okay? If you know the concept of the position sizing, in fact, the formula should be known how to calculate this trade size. And so each trade now is considered as made of two units. Let me be more specific with that. If we take, for example, the pound Aussie, the pound is made of 54 microlots, two units. This means that one unit is 27 microlots. When I will make my MX, I will close half of my trade, okay? An opportunity we have when we may have a big volatility in the market is when the price reaches the minimum level for an MX, okay, I can make my first MX. So your margin is only $515 on both trades, or it depends. It depends on the leverage the brokers give you, okay? But yes, the margin is always a small one. On this account, I think I have a margin of 100 to 1 or 200 to 1. Okay, now let me pay attention to what is happening. So I will not answer the question now because the price is reaching my minimum level. So let me pay attention here. Okay, I will make an MX on this level if the price comes back right on the white line. ANG, it depends on the broker. The leverage given by the broker depends on the broker and it depends on the account size, okay? Now, with a larger account, the leverage has a tendency to decrease until the minimum leverage the brokers give you. In USA, the leverage is 50 to 1. In Canada, the leverage is 50 to 1. But brokers, other brokers give 100 to 1, 200 to 1. Or you can Google you can search on Google and the leverage is indicated on each broker website. We do not recommend broker, okay? And if you have a good relationship with your broker and you have some interesting trading account, you can negotiate also with your broker. Once your broker knows you, you can negotiate also a larger leverage. Give me just one moment because I'm checking also my chart on my other PC where I have my complete template displayed. So, because we have an interesting phenomenon here on the pound Aussie for the max trader, you know that these levels where I have drawn my blue line correspond also to what we call a TT line. And so, which may be, or here I will make an MX on this one, or two. The price is really moving. I will make an MX here. The price is moving a little bit too fast. And you see here the size has been reduced by half. Okay. Now, by having made that MX on the pound US dollar, you can see that the risk has been reduced to 0.25%. Okay? Here I have missed my MX, so anyway, I will wait for another opportunity. So the pound US dollar, so the size, the trade size has been reduced by half. You can see in the account history, you see, the buy trade on the pound US dollar has been closed for 18 microlots with a profit. Okay. I'm going now to close. You have seen the mechanism. And when I will close one unit on the pound Aussie, if this opportunity happens, so I will show back again the trade here, the trade size. So 54 microlots divided by 2, it will be 27 microlots. Now in the pound US dollar, we have the opportunity to tighten our stop loss. On the pound US dollar, you see that the risk with the unit which has been closed has helped to reduce the risk by 0.25. And now I'm going to tighten this stop loss, okay? And I will tighten it in this area by just a few pips. And you will see that this helps to tighten further the risk on the trade. The first unit has closed here, closed profit, 0.25% profit, and we still have a risk on the second unit, which is still large enough to make the trade a potential losing trade. So we are not yet risk-free in this trade, okay? We have reduced the risk on the pound Aussie, but the trade is not yet risk-free, okay? I know that showing things in a demo account may be a bit frustrating, but this is not a trading room. We are not here to give you trades. If you take a trade, we have mentioned at the beginning of this session that it is for only educational purpose only. If you take a trade, it's under your own responsibility. And this is why we don't have a trading room. I make much more money trading myself than animating a trading room. No, I am in France. I'm not in UK, Hank. I am in France. So I am, as you have perhaps guessed with my accent, which is a bad English accent, by the way, I am a Belgian trader. And for many years I have lived in France and in Belgium, and today I have relocated definitively in France. So I live in France. Yeah, France. Very soon at the close of this blue candle, we will have the opportunity to tighten a little bit our stop loss, contributing to reduce somewhat the risk we have on that pair. If the price will come back on that line, depending how the price will move from that line, if it makes a small retracement from that line, I will make an MX2 as I have made here in this area for the pound US dollar. And by the way, for the maxers in the room, you can recognize also that in this area, something like that, we had also an interesting line on our template. We had also a TT line, so here in this area. So we had, in fact, a TT rejection like line, which was coincident, which was confluing with our max price level here. Okay. Okay, now the price is moving again nicely. I can tighten further my stop loss here Let me draw a vertical line here on this candle. We like to draw our exit setup line with a magenta vertical line, but it helps us also to adjust our stop loss that way, pound US dollar. And now you can see on the pound US dollar that I am virtually break even with the pound US dollar. I can, when I see such a number, minus 0.01%, I can tighten a little bit further the stop loss just to be break even or break even plus 1 pip, for example. And now I am risk free with the pound US dollar. Okay? And on the global position, when I consider the two trades, should the price reverse and hit the respective stop loss of these two trades, I am still at risk with minus 0.72%, so a little less than 0.75%, because I have not yet reduced the risk on this pound Aussie pair, except by tightening a little bit the stop loss. I can tighten a little further my stop loss, but not too much. And so tightening it further, I have reduced by one third by 30% the risk on the pound Aussie pair. And so from a risk of approximately 2%, because we had a risk of 1% per pair, so 2% for the two positions, now my global risk is only two-thirds of 1%. Okay, two-thirds of 1% for the two trades. So I'm not, for the moment, out of risk. I still may have a loss. Only the trade on the pound US dollar now is risk-free. This means that the potential loss on the second unit compensates for the profit on the first unit. And you can see that that tool gives us precious information. So what is the remaining risk on the trade? What is the potential profit made on the trade? And these two informations help us to fine-tune what we call the trade risk management process, so the way we handle a trade. By the way, this red candle, let me check here something. Sometimes we have to check in the data window. So this candle has closed, this one was an exit setup bar given especially by this indicator with the top of this store RSI. And once we have an exit setup bar, we define where to make our exit. But in this case, my exit would have not provided a profit large enough. So I use here my second alternative to make my first MX. So I want to make my first MX if the trade is a winning trade at or above that line. So in 30 seconds, these bars will close, and this will most probably give me the opportunity to reduce a little further the stop loss on the pound US dollar. Let's see that. Then second. Seconds. We don't need to rush. Okay, this candle has closed, and so now I can indeed tighten a little further my stop loss on this trade, the pound US dollar. So the minimum profit is 0.02%, so virtually break even. Now let's tighten a little bit the stop loss, and you will see that we will lock a little more profit on the sure side, on the certain side of these two positions, reducing also the global risk on the two trades. Unfortunately, I don't have the opportunity to tighten further my stop loss for the moment, but I will have soon the opportunity to make an MX on this candle, on this level, if the price reject again this level. So let's observe that. I hope that in the next 30-35 minutes we have for this session, we will have the opportunity to close the trade. Now let's observe the risk on the pound Aussie, as you can see, is -0.70%, so a little less than 0.75%. Let's observe what will happen to that number if I have the opportunity to close one unit. And let's observe also the global risk on the two positions, how an MX closing one unit helps to reduce that risk, or these two risks. One is for the present pair, and the other column, global, is for the two position. Globally, if I close the two trades now, we make 1.15% approximately, so a little more than 1%. You know that if you are able to make on average 1% per day, 1% per day, whatever the number of trades you take, but a global profit of 1%, and if you trade every day, which is not necessarily easy, okay? So you trade every day and you make an average of 1% per day, at the end of the year, by the compounding effect, you multiply your account by 10. Let's be ready to make an MX here on this line. No, not yet. We have 2 minutes. Let's wait for the close of this bar to see. Now let me show you the trade risk management. So here, okay? Let me show the terminal here. You see, for the pound Aussie, we have 54 microlots. And look at that number when I will make an MX here. Okay, let's make an MX now. You see, the trade size has been reduced by half. Okay, in the account history, now you have that unit being closed here. Okay. And you can see that this has reduced on the pound Aussie the risk. Now the trade is a risk-free trade. Even if the price hit my stop loss, I am risk-free. And now the two trades are globally also in a risk-free, and I am already locking a small profit. Okay? Last session, you presented a spreadsheet on this with the parameters. Can you repeat it again and send link? Indeed. Let me see if I have it under my end. Let me see if I can, first of all, let's wait for 40 seconds in such a way that I can most probably tighten my stop loss, Ralph. Okay? And I will show you the spreadsheet in one moment. So let's wait first of all for the close of this candle. Because as you can see, these trades with the max requires to be extremely attentive. Oh, I don't have the spreadsheet on this PC. I'm sorry for that. But you can ask for Craig to send you this spreadsheet. Okay? Now, I have the opportunity to tighten a little bit my stop loss here, only on this pair, on this level. And this will help me to lock a little more profit, as you can see, either on the pound US dollar or on my global position. No, and the trade does not reduce automatically. As you have seen, I have pushed on the MX button. And MX means, in our terminology, a momentum exit. And by pushing on the MX button, we close one unit of the trade, one unit being half of the trade size. Okay? And I'm pretty sure that with this blue candle, I will be able to tighten my stop loss on the pound Aussie pair. Now, because we have a scaling technique, I will not illustrate today, it's out of the scope of this session here. Because we have a scaling technique, and so along the trade we can add, we can make scalings. Each scaling is made of two units, so we add two units. And whenever we make an MX, we close one unit, okay? And always the oldest open unit, we follow the FIFO rules in this case. But this means that when we have to close the trade, it may happen that we are left with several open units. This is why we have a special button, which is called XXX. The XXX button closes all the remaining open units. So let me see if I have my spreadsheet somewhere else on this PC, because I would like to show. I'm not sure, but let me check. I don't have, let me see, perhaps somewhere else. In the meantime, I have to check. It's not easy to make two things at the same time. I don't have the spreadsheet here on this platform. I'm sorry for that. But you can send an email to Craig. His email is given, and so Craig gives regularly his email. So you can send him an email, and he will send you. So the spreadsheet, there is no problem, because this spreadsheet is available for free for those who attend our presentation class. Yeah, and the MX but closes one unit of the open trade. That's correct, Hank. You have seen, if you remember, the pound US dollar had a size of 36 microlot, and so we are now left with 18 microlot. The pound Aussie had an initial size of 54 microlots, and now the remaining open trade is 27. Okay? Yeah, one unit is simply half of the half size of the initial trade. One trade, whenever we open the trade, we consider it is made of two units. The MTM, our EA, calculates automatically the trade size, and one unit is 50% of the trade, of the trade size. So this candle will close in 4 seconds, so we will have most probably the opportunity to tighten the surplus. Yeah, a little bit here on the pound US dollar. Now with this candle, we don't have an exit rule. Yet we can tighten the stop loss on the pound Aussie dollar in a nice way now. And look how the risk will, or the locked profit will move on the pound, Aussie, and on the global position by tightening our stop loss on this level. Now we are locking a quarter of 1% on the pound Aussie, but globally almost 0.4% on the pound Aussie, on the two positions, sorry. And you can see that the stop loss are also adjusted on the terminal panel. You see on the pound US dollar, the stop loss is at 140.32.0 here on the terminal, and for the pound Aussie, the stop loss is at 182.488. So this means that our stop loss are always hard stop loss. Okay? This candle, if it closes as a red candle in the pound Aussie, will be an exit setup bar. Why? Because as you can see in the price, we have higher highs in the price, but we have lower highs in the store RSI. This is a divergence. You all know what a divergence is. This is one of our exit rules. And we will have one also in the pound US dollar. But the exit rule on the pound US dollar is something else. It's another exit technique given by the store RSI. And for the maxers, we are again in a TT rejection possibility here with that candle where the price is now located. So, and maybe perhaps a mid TT on the, pound US dollar. Yeah, we have a mid-TT rejection on the pound US dollar. So a max ETF standard trader would take also an exit on this level on the pound US dollar. Let's do that, okay? We have an exit setup on the pound US dollar. It is not shown on this chart. It is shown on our more complete template. Oh no, the price is moving, is resuming up. So let's stay in the trade. But otherwise, we had in this area an exit setup for the pound US dollar. And so what the standard max trader would do is define where the exit should be. And if the price hit that exit, they push on the MX button or the XXX button if they are left, for example, with only one open unit, or if they want to close their trades. But the price is moving nicely in our favor, so let's wait and see. Most probably at the close of this blue candle, we will be able to tighten further our stop loss, looking more profit on the two trades and so more profit on the global position. The price has still some volatility, but as you can see, the price is nicely trending due to the news release, in fact. Okay? So 45 seconds before the close of this candle, and I'm pretty sure we will be able to tighten further the two stop losses. To place my vertical line on this candle also, just to see where I can make my stop loss adjustment in 10 seconds now. Okay, in this case I can tighten further the stop loss. You see here, look how the number will evolve for the pound Aussie, 24 to here, or even here 30, and for the pound US dollar 15, and so here I can come up on this level, so 22. Now I'm looking a total profit of 0.5% on the two positions, okay? 1/3, almost 1/3 of 1% on the pound Aussie, and almost 1/4 of 1% on the pound US dollar. Now, if we close the trade now, you can see that the global profit is not too far away from 2%, 1% and 3/4 of 1%. It seems that some of you have some audio problem. Is it the case for the other members and the other participants in the room? Is my audio good, or has the audio some problems? Oh, sound is good there. Oh, okay. Sound and the video are good. Okay, so it may be on your side. Tiakoye, I'm sorry if I pronounce wrongly. I apologize for that. It may be on your side. No, Hank, we don't base the trade on a 20-to-1 or 200-to-1. The leverage, we don't care for the leverage. In fact, the leverage the brokers give you is used to calculate the margin you have to deposit when you open a trade. So if you have, for example, a margin of 100-to-1, this means that the margin when you open your trade is 1%. Now, with the position, I have to pay attention here because we may have an exit setup bar on this candle. So let's pay attention. With the position sizing concept we have, with the position sizing concept we have, the true leverage of our trade is, if we use a 2% risk for the trade, is between 4 and 10 to 1. The true leverage representing the how many times the trade size represents your trading account. And so if your trade size represents, let's say, 5 times your trading account, this means that you have a leverage of a true leverage for your trade of 5 to 1. No, the leverage is not changing in Europe. No. But there is something many traders do not understand. It's not because you have, let's suppose you have a leverage of 100-to-1, okay? And you have a trading account of $10,000. When you open a trade, this means that theoretically, it's not exactly true, but theoretically, you could open a trade having a size of 100 times 10,000. This means 1 million, okay? But this is not what we do. We want to have a smaller, real leverage for the trade, and with a 2% risk per trade, the leverage we have on the trade is between 4 and 10 to 1. It depends on the pair. It depends on the pips value of the pair. So it depends on several factors. But it is a small, real or true leverage. Okay. Okay. Now these candles have closed. I can first of all tighten further my stop loss. So on this level, approximately here and here for the pound Aussie, you can see that we are looking more profits on each trade and globally also. And let me check here on the pound US dollar. Yes, we have an exit setup bar with that blue candle, forcing me to consider an exit on that trade. At this, I must hide for the moment the terminal panel. And so if the price comes on this level here, here I will make an XXX. At 69.7. We are almost there, not yet. At 6.97, I will make... Okay, I make an XXX here, because the price has hit my exit level. Okay, so the trade on the pound US dollar is closed. Now, if I look on the terminal, you can see that I'm left with the pound Aussie. On the pound US dollar, I have made a profit of 0.69%, okay? And I am still in the pound Aussie. If I look at the account history, you can see that now the two units on the pound US dollar have been closed, both with a profit, okay? And I'm still left with the one opened unit. You see the number of opened units here, units open. On the pound Aussie. And with that candle here, if that candle closes as a red candle, I will have again, most probably, an exit setup triggering for this pair. If I close the trade now, I will make 1.6% profit. So any questions on these examples I have illustrated to you today, just to show you how, when we have an interesting movement after a news release, when all the conditions are fulfilled, how the MAX rules apply. And you have you, as you have seen, I don't make the decision afterwards. I explain when we have a setup bar, and I explain where I should make my decision, an open or a close, and if the price hit the level, then I push on the button either to open the trade or to close the trade. Okay? So things are not made afterwards, but always in live conditions. So here. Now, with such movement, with the MAX ETF standard level, we can, if the conditions are fulfilled, we can add to the trade, we can make scalings. In which case, this requires way, way more concentration and attention to handle the trade, because when we make a scaling, it's intuitively easy to understand we increase the risk on the trade, and this is why we do not make our scaling at random, or at a predefined distance from our entry level. There are other conditions to be fulfilled. And we have to consider carefully how we make our MX and how we tighten our stop loss. These are two important key decisions in the way to make the scalings, in the way to optimize the profits we can extract from a trade. By the way, you can see that on the two trades, even if the price hit the stop loss on the pound Aussie, we have locked 1% profit. This means that if you are able to do every day such kind of results, whatever the number of trades you make, at the end of the year, if you trade every day, which is not necessarily so easy to do, okay? Personally, I trade on average 2 to 3 days per week. But if you trade every day and you are able to make such kind of result per day, at the end of the year, by the compounding effect of your profits, you will multiply your account by 10. Okay, now with that candle having closed, this is not an exit setup bar, so we stay in the trade, and we have the opportunity to tighten a little more our stop loss, locking a little more profit either on the pair or on the global position. The trade has been closed on the US dollar. I can remove. Oh no, I will leave the panel just to show you, to show the two results of the two pairs. Now, such kind of trades on the non-farm payroll, what rule was the pound US dollar done? Dan, look the pattern made by the price. We have the three RB rules here, okay? This is the three RB rules. This candle was the setup bar of our three RB exit rule, okay? We give a name to our entry and exit setup in such a way they are easily recognized. And so you see the price continue to move upward and upward and upward. And so as long as we don't have the exit technique, we stay in the trade. And normally, this movement, you see from the, if I widen totally the chart, so this movement in fact has started in this area. The price has moved by 90 pips. This is what we call a true trend. A true trend. And when such a true trend happens, we have 75% probability for this movement to exhaust in that time period. Let me draw a rectangle here representing a time window. I will adjust the size of this rectangle, and usually it is drawn in red. Our friends call them the red magic box. And so, but it represents a time window, and so we have a 75% probability that this movement will exhaust inside that time period, as you can see around the Frankfurt and the London close. The margin would be $4 to trade 5.4 lots. It depends if you have a mini or a nano account type ang. Okay? And again, it depends on the margin the brokers give you. Okay? Personally, because we use always a small risk per trade, I don't take care of the margin, okay? Yeah, but the margin depends on the broker, Hank. It depends on the broker. And the margin is not the risk you are taking. This is something many traders are making a confusion. The risk you take in the Forex is not the margin. The margin is simply the deposit you have to deposit, the amount of money from your balance you have to deposit just to have the right to have the trade. And when the trade is closed, this margin comes back in your account. And the margin is not the risk you are taking. The risk you are taking is linked to the size of the stop loss and the financial risk you take on the trade, in this case 1%. And so in fact the risk is in this case 1% of the trade size. No, you don't need a lot of money in your account. No, that's not true. You know, if you have, for example, if you take a one standard lot on the pound US dollar, okay, what is the size? We have 5 minutes again. What is the size of one standard lot on the pound US dollar? It is, let me make a small educational training here. One standard lot on the pound US dollar is 100,000 pounds. Or, in this case, pound. Or, in this case, where is my end button? what is the quote, 140,000, let's say we are at 800, okay? $100, US dollar. So this is the size of one standard lot on the pound US dollar, okay? Now, if you have a 50-to-1 leverage, if you have a 50-to-1 leverage, so leverage, and this depends on your broker, leverage, 50-to-1, okay? This means, and this is the case in USA and in Canada, okay? Then the margin for that trade of one standard lot, the margin will be £2,000 or $2,816. Okay? This is the margin you have to deposit, £2,000, in USA with a leverage of 50-to-1. Okay? In USA, if you have a standard account, this means that in order to be able to trade one standard lot on the pound US dollar, you need a minimum size of $2,816 plus what you need to cover the stop loss, plus some buffer and the spread. Okay? Now, if you have your leverage is 100-to-1, then the margin will be half that number, this number. So the margin will be £1,000 or 1408 US dollar. Okay? Again, it depends on the pair. Okay? It depends on the pair. Very often 50-to-1 for the major, so the US dollar pairs, and sometimes smaller than 50-to-1 for the other crosses. It really depends on your broker. Okay? And so this means that if you want to trade in USA a pair like the pound US dollar or the euro US dollar, yeah, you need to have a trading account just to be sure of minimum $3,000 to $5,000. Okay? Now, don't forget that some brokers give you the possibility to open what they call mini account or nano account, for which, for example, if you have a mini account, the lot is 10,000 and not 100,000. So there is also a lot of confusions about traders about the size of the trade they can have with their broker, depending on the type of the type of account they have. Okay? I'm mentioning here what we have to pay for margins with a standard account. Okay? For which a standard lot size is 100,000 of the base currency. Now here on the pound Aussie, we are still in the trade, and I have no opportunity to tighten the stop loss, perhaps at the close of this candle. Let's have another look. In 24 seconds, 23 seconds. And so, in fact, when you open an account with a broker, you need to know what is the leverage the broker gives you for each pair. And so the margin is just the inverse of the margin. The margin is the inverse of the leverage. And you have to know also, if you keep your trades, for example, opened overnight, I've tightened my stop loss here, you have to know also what are the swaps which are applied to your account. Okay, now I'm looking a little more profit on my pound Aussie pair and also on the total profit. Now I'm potentially approximately potentially 2% profit. Okay? Okay, are there any other questions before we wrap up this session, because we are at the end of our 2 hours? And so you can see I can keep that trade open as long as I don't get an exit setup of any kind. So as I have explained, we have several types of exit techniques, and so one which can come very early later today could be, if the trade is still open, a timing exit techniques in that area. Okay, but anyway, any other questions about what you have seen today? By the way, for the max traders who are present in the room, when you know that you will have to make such an exit, okay, an exit, and the price is far away, you see 55 pips from your entry price level, you can, as you know, you can tighten further your stop loss, and I would, for example, tighten my stop loss in this area, looking much more profit on this pair. Let's wait for, let's adjust the stop loss, so somewhere, so here. And as you will see, when the price will be updated, this will tighten, this will lock way more profits. And for that, the price need to be updated on the platform. Oh, thanks, Ralph. The conditions were appropriate to have good movements today with the non-farm payroll. And so I remember, so I just remind you that to have good movements with the non-farm payroll, we need to have a big surprise in the non-farm payroll and an unemployment rate in agreement. So we had a negative, big negative deviation on the non-farm payroll and a negative number on the unemployment rate. Okay? I guess you'll need to move to France to trade, says Hank. Yeah, but you know, no, I don't think, Hank, because if we have a better margin or leverage in Europe than in USA, believe me, the profits we are making, okay, you see here the stop loss has been adjusted, so we are looking 0.8% on the pound Aussie, and we are looking 1.5% on the global, on the two trades. The great disadvantage we have in Europe here, Hank, is we pay taxes on our forex profit. Oh, the price is moving so fast, and if Cathy gives us still a few seconds, this now is what we call a long bar, but I have not been fast enough to make an XXX on this long bar. Otherwise, we have a rule, but when the price moves too fast, it's impossible. We would have made an exit in this area. Okay? But I'm happy to pay taxes, because when I pay taxes on my profit, this means that I make profits. Okay? So thank you very much for all your participation. So if you want any complimentary information, Craig has mentioned his email address. So maxtradesforyou@gmail.com. Don't hesitate. Feel free to send him your questions. And so he will be glad to answer your question. And in the meantime, I will continue to tighten my stop loss to lock more and more profit. You see, more than 2% if I close the trade now. That being said, I thank you very much for your participation and see you soon in one of our Max courses. And in the meantime, take care. Bye, everyone.